Greetings. This is Elder. This is Prophet West coming to you today briefly. I know I'm coming back. This is my third time coming back. But I just want to encourage you. I want to encourage you in the Lord. And because there's something that's getting closer. There's something that's brewing. Somebody say that God is up to something. Yes, God is up to something. And I can sense it and I can tell it. And all I want to do today, I want to encourage you to keep you going, because our job, my job, all of our job is to edify, encourage, and exalt. And so what I want to do, I want to edify you, I want to encourage you, and I want to exalt you. And if you saw my title, it is your eyes and your ears. Guard your eyes and your ears. You have to. The Bible says that love not the world, neither the things that are in the world, because all that's in the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, which is not of the Father, but is of the world. And anyone that loves the world, the love of the Father is not in them. And so this is why all through the Bible, as believers, Jesus tells us to guard our ears and our eyes, because even the Bible says that eyes haven't seen, nor ears heard, nor it has entered even into the heart of them that love the Lord. But also the Bible did say that God would hide some things from the wise and the prudent, but will reveal them unto babes. And that simply means a babe is a sincere, a mature, or an innocent heart, an open heart. And that's what God is looking for, open hearts, because God wants to impress, God wants to reveal his power. He want to in your heart, because the Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord goes to and fro the earth, seeking those who have a perfect heart before him. In other words, when your heart is sincere, your heart is open, that's what God wants. God wants your heart. He don't just want your mouth, but he wants your heart. Because if he know he can get your heart, he can get your mouth. And so God is after your heart. That's why Jesus, all through the Bible, has said to take heed how you hear. That means to guard the way you hear, because Jesus know, and he knew, and he said in the Bible that in the last days there would be a famine in the land. Not of natural bread and water, but of hearing of the word of God. And there's a famine where people's ears have become dull to hearing, because you got people's ears that are itching for things, of itching ears, going from place to place, trying to find something that's going to gratify them instead of wanting to know the truth. And so we're living in that day where people are, the Bible also said that you got people who are ever learning, but never coming to the knowledge of the truth. They're learning the word. They're learning and studying, but the revelation of who God is, it's not in them. It's almost like the Bible is like a book. It's like a book. It's like a storybook. But the Bible is more than a storybook, because underneath the letters of the word, there is a hidden door. There are secrets and mysteries. And God is revealing to them, to those who have a perfect heart. And say, God wants to have an encounter with you. And see, that's why he wants you to guard, to take heed how you hear. Also, that word obey, he tells us to obey. Obedience is better than sacrifice. That simply means to be still. God wants us to be still, because he wants to speak a certain word in your spirit. He wants to speak instructions in your ears, because there's an activation that's taking place, that he wants to take place in your spirit, in your heart. Because the Bible says that the same spirit that raised up Jesus Christ from the dead, it shall quicken your mortal body. In other words, it's going to make you alive. It's going to make you alive. Where you don't understand, it's going to make it alive. Where you don't see, God's going to open your eyes up, and where it's going to come alive. See, but that's what the eyes are all about. See, eyes are how you perceive, how you gather, how you see. That's why he said, take heed how you hear, take heed how you perceive. Because based on how you perceive, we will determine how you process what goes in you. And how you process what goes in you is going to be determined by what comes out of you. And so that's why you have to be careful. Take heed. That means to listen. That means to pay attentive ear to what God is saying. Because in that there's power, in that there's life, and in that there's a seed. Because with words there's seed. See, God wants to give you his seed of wisdom, his seed of joy, and his seed of deliverance. And so that's why the Bible said, even for those that have a broken heart, he said that he's nigh unto the broken heart. Because when your heart has become broken, that means your heart has become crushed. That means your heart is open wherein he can speak to you. because your heart has become sensitive. You're crushed. Your world is crushed. And in a crushed place, God can bring, God can speak, and he can bring deliverance. But also he can mend it back together. Because God says that, God said the contrite spirit, he will save the contrite spirit, the broken spirit. And so if your spirit is broken, if your spirit is contrite, if you've been crushed, if your heart has been crushed, God is talking to you. He wants you. He wants you. He wants to have a relationship with you. So that's why he said to take heed how you hear. And see, because you have to be careful of how you hear, because based on natural soul, your natural ear is connected to your flesh. And that's what it accuses of the brothers, that he will get in your ear. And what he will do, he will put a subliminal thought, a power of suggestion, a thought that's not true. And if you entertain it, it's going to take root. And then you're going to take on the characteristics of it, because it's going to be sweet to your mouth, but it's going to be bitter to your stomach, because the devil, he's going to come as an angel of light. That's why the Bible tells us that we must watch as well as pray. Them eyes again, watch. That means your eyes got to be up. You got to perceive. That means you got to be vigilant. You got to be focused. Because in you becoming vigilant and you becoming focused, you can see the enemy when he comes. That's why he tells us to put on the whole armor of God, that we might be able to withstand against the wiles of the enemy. And when you put on the whole armor of God, that means your eyes are open. You can see what the adversary is doing. You can see what the adversary is trying to do. But in closing, your ears and your eyes. Jesus talked about it throughout the body. Guard them. Guard your eyes. Guard your ears. Don't just totally pay attention to what you see. Because we don't walk by what we see, but we walk by what we know. And that's in our heart. That's the word. And so that's why God wants to have a heart-to-heart relationship with you. He wants you to get closer to you. Because the more that he get closer to you, the more he can change your ears. And the more he can change your eyes. I hope this makes sense. Guard your ears and your eyes. Guard your ears and your eyes. Because in your ears and your eyes is the passageway that can get to your heart. It is, because the Bible says out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. And see, that's why many people are walking upon the curse, because they allow bitterness. They allow hurt. They allow jealousy. They allow the spirit of competition. They allow all those things to get in their heart, to get in their spirit. And what happened is taking root, and it's taking root, and it's bearing the fruit. And because of that, doubt is coming out. Contention is coming out. Hate is coming out. Jealousy is coming out. Pride is coming out. And all that family is coming out. And what it's doing is blocking many people from receiving a blessing, because they didn't pay attention. They didn't listen. They didn't focus. Because, see, the thing about it, in a classroom, the student that listen to the teacher the most and pay close attention, the closest attention to him, and take the most notes, and take the most notes, they are the one that's going to pass the test. They're the one that's going to have a good grade, because they took the time. They paid attention. They listened to everything, everything, fine detail, everything. And if we listen to the fine detail, and you process and you perceive exactly what God is saying, you're going to be blessed. God bless you.